head coach of the visiting team is Quinn Snyder.
Let's be your Memphis Grizzlies! At small forward, standing 6'8", number one, Kyle Anderson. At the shooting guard position, at 6'6", number 24, Dylan Brooks. The other forward position, 6'10", number 13, Jaren Jackson. The big man, 6'10", number 17, Jonas Valanciunas. Starting at the other guard, at 6'3", number 12, John Morant. The head coach for your home team is Taylor Jenkins. Ladies and gentlemen, yo, Memphis Grizzlies!
It's time for the NBA, live on 2K Sports. Welcome, everyone, to the broadcast table. Chris Webber to my right, Greg Anthony to my left. I'm Kevin Harlan, and David Aldridge on our sideline. Hey, Dave.
Well, Rudy Gobert is still awaiting his first All-Star appearance. His snub in 2019 raised eyebrows. The reigning Defensive Player of the Year averaged a career-high 15 points a game on a league-best 65% shooting from the field. And he missed a $1 million contract bonus due to that snub. Kevin, it's easy to see why he was emotional about it.
Yeah, D.A., very understandable. Thank you. And let's check out a breakdown. Looking at some stats for Morant.
He's been playing a much bigger role in their offense over the past five games. It comes across in his usage rate, which has gone up during that stretch. We'll see if they continue to lean on him here tonight.
And checking out Utah's opening lineup, Conley runs the point with Mitchell flanking him. Inside, we have Ingles and Gobert. And it's O'Neal in at the small forward position. And for Memphis, Jackson and Valanciunas, they're in the middle. Morant and Brooks manning the backcourt. And it's Anderson in at the three slot. We've got a terrific front court matchup tonight. Chris, you were the prototypical four when you played. Who is the toughest power forward you had to defend?
Okay, well, I'm going to give you the same answer I always have. When I was in the West Coast, any given week, this is who I had to guard in a week's time. Tim Duncan, Garnett, Nowitzki, Rasheed Wallace, Robert Horry, Karl Malone. That was all in the West Coast, and I think I played in the golden era of power forwards, and so I would just say put all their names in the hat, pick one out, and that's who was the toughest, because it was like that every night.
Hall of Famers, including yourself. So the Utah Jazz able to put the first points up on the board. Pass to Brooks. Lock at six. To the right side. Three-pointer. Hell good from Valanciunas. Ingles with the ball. He's picked up by Brooks. Kicks it out to Mitchell. The shot's good on the assist by Ingles.
He's so aggressive at that end of the floor, and that's a quality all great scorers have.
A floater, and Morant will lay it in.
First basket. Do that every time up the floor. Put Morant in the pick and roll, and just let him go to work.
Now here's Conley. D right on him. Stolen by Brooks. Little over a minute 30 into this first quarter. Dishes it to Morant. Brooks against Conley. Six to shoot. Brooks misses. Jackson against O'Neal. There's the pass to Conley. Ingles with the ball. Back to Conley. Releases. That shot off. Grizzlies have gone just 1-4 to get this game started. Brooks dishes to Valanciunas. Brooks kicks to Morant. Knocks it loose. Mitchell with it. He's picked up by Morant. Whistle blows. Bucket is good. And he'll have a chance at the line to make it a three-point play.
First.
I tell you what, you better watch out, fellas. He is on fire here today.
And the Utah Jazz, not exactly a magnet for big-name free agents, Greg, but for their young star, Donovan Mitchell, it has been a perfect fit.
You know, they needed a scorer. He's played big minutes from day one and really thrived in that role.
One shot.
Free throw drops for Mitchell.
And you ask around, his coaches and teammates love Donovan Mitchell. The way he carries himself, really infectious, upbeat, but also a born competitor.
Now here's Brooks, coming off a solid outing against Charlotte. Here's Jackson. Gobert pulls it in.
Just 1-for-5 from the field now. I mean, they've come out flat. They need to pick up the energy.
O'Neal passes to Conley. Pass to Mitchell. Lets it go with a three. Score it. His third straight basket in three tries. And going into the 2017 draft, Mitchell was a sleeper. Maybe even Greg to himself, he wasn't sure he was ready to make that leap.
And you know, Kevin, it was the NBA players he was working out with in the summertime who told him, man, you're ready right now. And a season that saw him second in Rookie of the Year votes validated that and built his confidence.
Two on the clock, and here's Anderson for three. Rebounded by the Jazz. They're coming off that win against the Nets.
Well, it's easy to score when you're facing very little resistance. That's why their offense looks so good in that one.
But you also got to give credit to the offense, too. I mean, they exploited every hole they saw in the defense.
The Jazz have made their only other free throw attempt today in an earlier trip to the line.
Not really where you'd like to be as a team in terms of free throw shooting, just about 73%.
And he knocks down the first one. In the new season, Chris, every team wants that fast start. But when you really think about it, how important is that in the grand scheme of things?
Well, it depends on where you are. Like, let's think about Houston last year with the injuries. You don't want to get to a slow start where you're fighting for home court advantage. So it's very important. And usually veteran teams know that first 2-3 weeks of the season is when you can sneak teams. And if you're a younger team and you understand that, wait a minute, it's all about attention to detail, focus, and playing hard, you can get some pretty nice upsets early. Because in the, for young teams, once the scout report comes out and teams hone in on you, it might be a little bit more of a difficult
look
season
out.
As the games go ahead. Yeah, watch out.
The Grizzlies with another miss. And it's Utah's ball. It's a 12-2 run here. Good pace. O'Neal kicks to Conley. Now Mitchell. Playing Brooklyn. He was nearly unstoppable. No good. His first miss after three makes.
A fantastic effort on D to get up in his face and deny the layup.
Brooks feeling it out a bit. Passes it to Jackson. Valanciunas trying to free himself up. Jackson misses. Utah leading by 10. On the wing, Mitchell. From outside, off the mark. And here's Melton. He'll bring it up for Memphis. It's Brooks on the wing.
Jazz foul.
Yeah, Kevin, the front office shakeup this summer for the Grizzlies. Now, the new leadership wants to take more of a long-term proactive
approach. Shooting for Memphis. First trip to the line for him here.
Two shots!
And that one falls for Brooks.
45th pick in the 2017 draft. Remember when Brooks led Oregon to the Final Four?
The Grizzlies making a switch here. Clark's checked in. And both free throws good for Brooks. Here is Conley. Another guy who really kicked it up a notch for them in that game against the Nets. Now the dish to Mitchell. Gobert down low. Guarded by Valanciunas. And it goes down 2 points.
They've been beating them to a lot of those loose balls and rebounds here to start.
So timeout called here. The first for Memphis. Well, they call Rudy Gobert the Stifle Tower. Probably the game's most dominant rim protector.
And in today's game, that's not enough. You also have to come out of the paint and defend smaller players and switches. He straddles those two needs better than anyone in the league.
In for Royce O'Neal. Here we are in November. Let's see how things are shaking out in the West early in the season. Look at Utah. They reside in the seventh slot right now in the early part of the season. And of course, there's the Grizzlies. They're down in seventh place.
And I think for the Jazz, they had the kind of hot and cold start that we've kind of come to expect. Nothing that would indicate they're in for any kind of a breakout season.
They do look like they're the same kind of team they were last year. Good, but not special.
The Grizzlies shoot their third and fourth free throw shots of the night.
And as a team, really just middle of the pack in terms of their percentage from the line at about 76.
The free throw drops for Valanciunas. And the emphasis on mobility, a challenge for lumbering seven-footers like Valanciunas.
Well, yeah, I mean, you're not going to be the quickest when you're 7 feet tall, Kevin. I mean, in order to earn his keep, he has to be dominant inside. I mean, he has that capability.
George Niang, he's checked in for Joe Ingles. So one for two that time at the stripe. And we've seen stars, Chris, get suspended in the playoffs for having seven technical fouls. Did we modify that rule at all, do you think?
You know, I think it can be tweaked if everyone agrees on it. But for me personally, I don't think that we've had enough superstar players get suspended with that rule to say let's change the number. We definitely want superstar players to play in the playoffs, to play for their fans. But we also want to keep the integrity of the game. And if technicals means I get to yell at the referee more, well, then maybe I just have to have more discipline on my end and say, wait a minute, I can't do this because it's going to hurt the team. So I'm not sure about that yet. Tells you a little something about their team. They've been able to pull in front despite his troubles.
Quick off the floor and powerful. Clark loves to attack that rim.
Now here's Conley, one of the dependable scorers on the team. He's averaging close to 17 points a game. Shoots from 14. A shot missing. Now Memphis takes it the other way. They defeated Charlotte in their last game.
Well, you look at the points they produced in that game. Great adjustments on the offensive end.
In-game adjustments are critical. They did an awesome job taking what the defense gave.
Here is Conley following the score by Memphis. And the rejection by Valanciunas.
Oh, a good shot blocker who competes hard on defense. Defenders better think twice before trying Valanciunas.
And it just seems that every pass they make is leading to a score. Just great ball movement.
Utah's gone 1-2 from long range in the first quarter. Kindly the pass to Gobert. Outside Conley. Here's Mitchell. Another miss by Utah.
This quarter has been hit or miss for him. Mostly miss.
Memphis moving it around. And that one's good by Clark.
And this has been a great job of just getting into the middle of that defense and really scoring effectively from the paint.
And a first timeout is down called for Utah.
And they just can't seem to get going offensively.
They might be pressing a little bit, forcing some things. This is a good opportunity to calm everyone down.
Vacation, I'm living, got so many Benjamins, they think I'm getting it printed. Hey. I came with them,
what's up?
This still living in crib. You can't even comfort a kid. Give it to me. Want some money? Shit, just set it with money.
Changes here for the Grizzlies. Gorgui Dangs checked in for Jonas Valanciunas. And Allen subbed in for Dylan Brooks. The Jazz also changing it up. Ed Davis has checked in for Donovan Mitchell. And Emmanuel Mudiay subbed in for Mike Conley. Here's Niang. He's been patient so far. Nothing on the scoreboard yet. They get it back. Gobert. And slam dunk by Gobert.
Nothing soft about the putback there.
And why chance it, right? Take the dunk if you've got it.
Yeah, guys, but where was the box out? No excuse letting him roam that freely on the glass.
Here's Clark. He had a 15-point outing in their last game against Charlotte.
Yeah, his energy level in that game was amazing. He did all that work offensively and controlled the boards, too.
Looking nimble on the drive there. Once Clark sees an opening in the defense, he's looking to exploit.
And it's Memphis on the break. Here's Melton, and they convert at last on attempt number three. And it's a 4-point Grizzly lead. Up top, Mudiay. He had an 18-point outing in the last game against Brooklyn. 1:22 left here in the opening quarter.
You know what, though? Sometimes you can be too open. I think it may have surprised him, and that's why he missed.
Allen dishes to Clark, and he banks in the layup. Clark's got 10 points.
Clark!
This quarter expending tremendous energy at the offensive end. He's not slowing down. He's still calling for it.
Mudiay kicks to Clarkson. Let's it fly. Another miss by Utah. And here are the Grizzlies. They're on a 20-4 run. Here's Melton, defended by Mudiay. Here's Clark, trying to get open as Jang. It falls for the sixth time in seven tries this contest. That's 86%. Jazz trail by eight. They've been looking out of sync offensively.
Yeah, their offense has ground to a standstill.
Ball's knocked loose and stolen by Jang. The shot and game clock separated by four. Two free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul.
Personal. The potential is there. For Clark, it's about expanding the range so that it makes him more versatile offensively.
Two for Memphis, they have gone 3 of 4 at the free throw line tonight. And that one falls for Clark. And he makes both free throws. And so Clarkson will bring it up for Utah, trailing by 10. This, of course, their first opportunity to play Memphis this season.
And even though they're one of the top teams, they dropped the season series to this squad. So sometimes matchups play a role.
Now, here's Clarkson. Coming in off a 21-point game, his last outing. Clock is at 3. From deep three-point range. So as we end the first quarter, already a double-digit ball game. Grizzlies lead by 10. Live from the FedEx Forum, you're watching 2K Sports. One of the better two-way guards in the NBA, Mike Conley, said his inspiration growing up was none other than Gary Payton.
I just went and cut my dread, but I got some beautiful hair.
He was one of my favorite players growing up. I had Gary Payton jersey, had the shoes, everything. So when I looked at a player, I was like, you know, he plays on both ends. I want to be able to do that too.
Dean O'Connell, maybe not the size of Payton, but Greg, he's always taken the challenge defensively.
And you can see how much of an influence the glove had on Conley. He plays a lot like him on that end.
Rudy Gobert.
And so far through one quarter, it's been a lopsided game. We'll see if that changes here in the second. Guys, what's your take on the Grizzlies so far?
You got to credit their defense, communicating, rotating, making plays on the ball.
No question. It's been stifling thus far, preventing that offense from establishing any kind of rhythm.
And so in the game for the Jazz, Gobert is out there with Davis. Then there's Jordan Clarkson. Then it's Moutier, and it's Niang in at the three spot. Now here's Morant. He picked up 27 points in their last win against the Hornets in Charlotte.
As good of a score as he was in that game, he was even a better passer. A lot of assists for him.
O'Neal's check in for the Jazz. Now here's Morant. To the middle. It's stolen by Moutier. And we're starting the second quarter, about a minute gone. He gets that one.
And those are the kind of nice inside looks they've gotten here in the first half.
Morant with it. He averages over 27 points a game and seems to always find a way to score. Five on the clock. And Davis sends it back. And they'll keep possession.
And battling hard on the glass, they hold the advantage here so far.
Pass to Niang. Morant with the steal. And it's Memphis on the break. Here's Anderson. And that one clearly a foul. Gets the whistle and two shots coming up. Emmanuel Moutier picks one up.
A wildly unpredictable player. Anderson is skilled at drawing the
shooting from Memphis
and then making him get overly assertive.
And Chris, in his sixth season out of UCLA, small forward Kyle Anderson.
Kevin, in his first 3 years, improving his long-range distance, shooting to over 37%. Now, it's fallen back off the last couple of seasons, but he's a smart, savvy player, and he's at his best when he's hitting shots.
That free throw good from Anderson. Good shot selection, largely dependent on getting open. Which players do the best job of moving, you think, right now without the ball?
Period. Klay Thompson, 60 points, 11 dribbles. Did you hear me?
I got it.
60 points, 11 dribbles.
It almost looks like a misprint, doesn't it?
Yeah, it is.
That one misses. And out of UCLA, forward Kyle Anderson. Some call him slow-mo. Why is that?
Well, I mean, not the most athletic player. It's his size and IQ for the game, though, that makes him so effective.
Now here's Morant. And here's Jackson. Right wing. Down to five on the shot clock. And that one's good. Morant.
Yeah, right there, Morant showing his ability to work off the ball. I mean, he found some space and knocked down the shot.
Moutier passed to Niang. With some arc. And the rejection by Jackson.
A good board there, Kevin. But overall, they're getting slightly out-rebounded.
Anderson, the bounce pass. Now, Morant. And good that time. Morant's got 4 points now in the quarter.
Just to make him a little more unstoppable, Morant's developed a deadly teardrop.
Can they get it? And the rejection by Jang. Here's Morant. 6 points for him. High arcing shot. Here's Jang. And that'll be two free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul.
Yeah, way to play in attack mode and get to the line.
This is his first free throw of the game.
Gorgie Jang. Two shots.
First free throw is good. Brooks checked in for Memphis. Mitchell, he's checked in for the Jazz. Mike Conley comes in for Emmanuel Moutier. That's also good. So he hits both free throws.
Oh, he's such a good free throw shooter. I mean, it frees him up to be as aggressive as he wants in the post.
Right side, Conley. Stolen by Anderson. And it's Memphis on the break. Anderson with the ball. Here's Morant. And another miss by Memphis. Jazz trail by 15. To the paint, here's O'Neal. The shot's good on the assist by Ingles. O'Neal's got 4 points in the quarter.
Taking it up strong against size, he does not lack for confidence.
No, absolutely not. And in his mind, no one can stop him on that, no matter the size.
Now here's Anderson. He's usually able to provide some lift to his team, averaging 6 points a game. Four on the shot clock. Shoots from 14, and it's good off the back rim at the end.
Oh, man, a sound perimeter shooter who massively improved his jump shot over the years. A testament to Anderson's work.
Conley, the pass to Davis. He kicks it to Mitchell. And denied, he sends it right off the glass. Now here's Anderson. He's usually able to provide some lift to his team, averaging 6 points a game. Morant passes to Jang. On the wing, Brooks. Ingles covering. Memphis needs to get off a shot here. Here's Jackson. The putback controls the rebound and puts it back up and in. And the Grizzlies lead by 17.
And those second chance points really become almost like bonus points when you can get them.
Ingles with the ball. He had a 15-point outing in their last game against Brooklyn. Back to O'Neal. Conley finds Davis. Shoots over Morant. And misses it off the right side of the rim.
Oh, he found open space for mid-range. Just maybe rushed his release a little bit.
Yep, that one goes in there. Morant's got 8 points.
This is why I love his game. You really have to admire his tenacity.
Davis, the pass to Mitchell. And stolen by Jang. Here's Brooks. That shot, no good. And it's Utah the other way. Here's the teardrop. And he's fouled pretty hard on that shot, but he's got the chance to pick up the points at the line.
All the officials are all over that one.
There's more and more. We're seeing star players give their sneakers to fans at the end of games. Did you ever do that?
Oh, yeah, man. Especially when I was with Dada, I would give a pair of shoes away after every game.
Oh, great.
Really love doing it on the road. At home is really cool, but on the road is great because that's where you know that fan braved all those other fans and the elements to wear your jersey and to be the only one there. So you look for that kid. I used to look for the kid with the number 4 Weber jersey and be like, hey, kid, I know what you went through to wear that tonight. You make sure you go home with these bragging rights. Tell them these are fresh from the game when we beat your team, baby.
Yeah, that's a neat way to connect.
Yeah.
Catching up on the changes for Memphis. Valanciunas is checked in for Anderson. Clark comes in for Jackson. And it's DeAnthony Melton in for Morant. Gobert, he's checked in for the Jazz. So he comes up empty, missing both. Memphis with the ball. Some momentum with a 15-2 run underway. The pass to Valanciunas. It's stolen by Gobert. And here is Conley. Pass to Mitchell. Just 5 on the clock. From the stripe. No good off the back of the rim. Now the Grizzlies with it. Some momentum with a 15-2 run underway. And there's the call on Rudy Gobert.
Jazz foul.
That's his first foul.
Personal foul. 14 foul. Substitution for the Grizzlies. Number 23.
Here's Melton. He has 5. 6 on the shot clock. Clark dishes to Valanciunas. Finds the hole for the second time from the floor. Now 2 for 5.
Yeah, they're going to have a nice little run here.
Jazz trail by 21. Now Conley. Ingles with the ball. Now Valanciunas defending. Knocked away. And now the Grizzlies. Fast break. Ingles with the rebound.
Those are chances.
Jonas,
almost always you can rely on him to get you 2 points, but the D, just enough to keep him out of rhythm.
Utah calls timeout. And last season, Jonas Valanciunas averaging the fewest minutes of his career. Greg, at the same time, he was playing the best basketball of his career.
I mean, his scoring per minute through the roof. Rebounding at a career high level. He can dominate inside, especially at that offensive end.
Clarkson's checked in. The three-point game, such a big part of the NBA. Let's see the best teams at it. Second, the Grizzlies.
No doubt, they have snipers on that roster, that's for sure. It's been a terrific year for them from beyond the arc.
Gobert finds Clarkson. Now Mitchell. Their offense, stone cold. Another miss there. And the Grizzlies leading by 23.
2 minutes remaining in the first half. 2 minutes.
Here's Melton. He's got five. Gobert with the block. Pass break. Here come the Jazz. Here's Mitchell. Lays it up and in off the pretty assist. Mitchell's got 10 points in the game.
You gotta love his hustle, leaving the defense no time to react.
And how about then not settling? I mean, instead of being lazy with the shot selection, they go right to the rim.
It's good.
Big miscommunication on defense. He recognizes it and quickly takes advantage.
Yeah, they're pouring it on right here, trying to give the opposition no light at the end of the tunnel.
And he gets the whistle. Two free throws coming up.
And already over a decade in the league for Mike Conley. He never got past the numbers game to make the All-Star team in the crowded Western Conference. But make no mistake about it, Conley is star caliber.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
And the first one at the line is good. And Greg, you talked to Conley. He'll admit he's been frustrated trying to break through and get that recognition.
Still, the way he plays the game, not focused on his individual numbers, unselfish, and focused on what the team needs to win.
The Jazz making a switch here. Niang's checked in, and so Mike Conley nails both of them.
Now look, he's an elite defender at his position. Conley also contributes in many different ways on the offensive end.
Melton feeling it out a bit. Valanciunas inside. Gobert on him, and there's the whistle. 3 second violation. Moutier, he's checked in for Mike Conley. .102 left to play in the first half. Now here's Moutier. He's guarded closely. Mitchell outside. Back to Moutier. Five to shoot. A steal and another turnover here by Memphis.
Jazz ball.
Grayson Allen's checked in for Dylan Brooks.
Grayson Allen.
Jazz trail by 21, and Gobert kicks to Clarkson. The shot from the low post is good.
This is why you like the size in the backcourt, if you can get it. I mean, Clarkson able to take the hit and complete the play.
The Grizzlies shooting 53% in the second quarter. Good ball movement, yielding good looks. Now 8 seconds separating the two clocks. Here's Valanciunas. Gobert pulls it in. Gobert's got rebound number 9 now. What an effort here tonight. Moutier passes to Mitchell. Whistle blows. Basket is good. So a chance here for a 3-point play.
How about that move? Is this guy special or what? Just love watching him operate inside.
Three trips to the line so far for him in this one.
He struggled mightily at the free throw line in their last game.
One shot.
Free throw drops for Mitchell. Here's Melton from deep. And that one released in time, but no good. And through one half, it hasn't even been close. Memphis out in front, up by 16. Got a chance now to send it over to David Aldridge, standing by courtside. David.
Thank you, Kevin. Here with Coach Quinn Snyder. Quinn, what concerns you most about the first half?
Well, I think the tempo is in their favor right now. They're fast, and they're getting up and down the floor, so they're running out in transition.
Got to beat them to the punch. Thanks very much, Coach. Back to you, Kevin.
Thank you, David. We'll be back after halftime for the start of the second half momentarily.
It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hey again, everybody. I'm Ernie Johnson. Shaq is here. Kenny's here. You're watching the NBA Halftime Show on 2K Sports. It's Memphis out in front at the half. They're leading by 16. Kenny?
Well, they just about ran their offense to perfection. They pounded the ball inside, and the entry feeds were on time and on the money. It was a clinic to watch. The second half is going to be no contest if they keep getting shots 8 feet and in.
How about you, Shaq? What did you think about Utah?
They were brick city, and it was painful to watch. Weak shooting starts to get contagious. They were struggling all over the place. They got to work on getting more high-quality chances, more layups, fewer prayers.
And that does it for our halftime show. We now take you back to Kevin Harlan for the start of the third period.
And after a very lopsided first half, we'll see if things play out a little more evenly here in the second. Jazz trail by 16. Morant and Brooks manning the backcourt. Jackson and Valanciunas, they're in the middle. And it's Anderson in at the three. And that's the group for Taylor Jenkins as we begin the second half.
Oh, the floor general skills of Conley. I mean, he has a fantastic feel for when his teammates need the rock.
Now here's Morant, covered by Conley. And finished up by Morant.
Taking matters into his own hands.
Yeah, we didn't expect to see that kind of finish.
No, but his teammates love that kind of energy, fellas. I mean, dunks like this demonstrate leadership.
So it's Utah now. Grizzlies making the shot.
And a quick look at the numbers for Gobert. First in rebounds, first in blocks, and with a top 20 ranking in field goal percentage, you put the ball in his hands, and he converts at a remarkable rate.
And just going back real quick to the fact that he's tops in the league in rebounds, what a tremendous feat. What a monster he is in the paint. Free throw drops for Mitchell. And so he hits both. The Grizzlies leading by 14. Anderson outside. It's a floater. Gobert with the block. And it's Conley penetrating. Mitchell, it's deflected.
I love Morant's approach to the game. I mean, flying to the ball, challenging everything.
And it's Anderson that time on the assist by Brooks. Brooks has got three assists now in this one.
And that's why you don't let him get positioned deep in the post.
No, just too big of a threat down there. He has a number of go-to moves at his disposal.
Chalk up two there. That's now 8 points for Rudy
Gobert. He's such a dependable facilitator. Conley knows it's his responsibility to share the wealth with his guys.
Here's Valanciunas. Gobert with the block. Here's Mitchell. And it's Mitchell with the jam.
And didn't do anything fancy there, but didn't need to.
Nope, he, his only concern right now is getting the points on the board. And I don't mean style points. Now here's Morant. He's got 10. Rebounded by Donovan Mitchell.
And the activity he shows around the rim is why he is such a respected defender.
Yeah, you can see why he's established that reputation. Strong understanding of how to defend at the rim.
Here's Mitchell after the made shot from Jonas Valanciunas. And another shot. And Mitchell with the layup. Mitchell's got 8 points here in this quarter.
Second chance points always hurt. There's not enough effort to block out.
Yeah, that's what's frustrating, because you did the job defensively to get the stop, and then you gave it right back.
Timeout called, the Grizzlies. As the teams head into this timeout, a chance for the coaches now to map out some plays for the next few minutes and a chance for the players to rehydrate with some Gatorade. That's important if they want to make sure they don't wear down later in the game.
Absolutely. Over the course of a game, you have to stay hydrated.
Stand up on my shoulders. Tell me what you see. I am a giant. We'll be breaking borders.
The small forwards with the fastest hands in the league and generating the most steals per game. Fifth on the list, Kyle Anderson.
I mean, if you're an opposing small forward, this could also be called a list of the league's most annoying players. I mean, they will be in your jersey all night when you're up against them.
Oh, yeah, Greg. These guys are stoppers. There is no assignment too tough for them.
Now here's Morant. He's got 10. Gobert with the block. And now Utah, fast break.
Oh, and the dunk by Mitchell.
And Kevin, even though they're down, he's still looking to do the spectacular, and he did.
Well, maybe this is the best time to do it. Here's Morant. On the wing, Brooks. Six to shoot. Anderson wide open, and another miss by Memphis.
I didn't see that miss coming. I mean, he's usually been money from that range.
And Davis has checked in for the Jazz.
Jazz substitution, Eddie Davis.
And it's Davis with the ball for Utah.
And you look back at that 2013 draft, just call it the year of the sleeper Euros. Giannis Antetokounmpo taken 15th, and this guy, Rudy Gobert, selected with the 27th pick.
Here's Morant, following the basket by Donovan Mitchell.
Morant. And with the lead, I like the strategy here. Continue to get the ball to guys who can do something with it.
Oh, I do too, Greg. You have to go to your best scorers. I mean, it's a smart strategy, and so far, it's paying off in this game.
So it's the Jazz now, following the basket by Ja Morant. And, you know, Greg, hindsight always being 20-20. But Greek Freak and Gobert probably go first and second in that 2013 draft.
Yeah, and Stephen Adams probably top four. The common thread, all of them play a hard-nosed style, not something that's always associated with foreign-born players. But they're erasing that perception.
Free throw drops for Mitchell. And that one goes in. Two from the line that time.
Wow, they've made every free throw here in the second half.
Outside Jackson. Out to the right wing. Here's Morant. The shot will not fall. The Jazz go the other way with it. Mitchell wide open. open. Another miss by Utah.
And they continue to control the glass.
Brooks kicks to Morant. Pass to Valanciunas. Jackson trying to break free.
Good.
Jonas Valanciunas.
Valanciunas has got 4 points this quarter.
Oh, how about Valanciunas from there? He likes mixing in the shot whenever he can.
Now here's Conley. Tight defense on him. Good work there as it goes. Conley's got six.
That's just great touch. The teardrop, well, that's all about feel.
Here's Morant. And the layup is good. And the Grizzlies lead by 10.
Yeah, wiry, strong, and courageous. Morant's willing to slam it up in there if you give him a lane.
Davis looking for an opening. He feeds it to Ingles. And the rejection by Valanciunas. Now here's Morant. 14 points for him. Jackson up top. And here's Anderson from the arc. Offensive rebound. And the second chance effort by Jackson. And now a 12-point Grizzly lead.
That is really good work there on the offensive glass.
Utah calls timeout.
Well, his father played in the NBA. He grew up in Indiana. His father was a teammate of mine, Jaren Jackson, over at the Wizards. He took on Jordan and those guys. Let me get back to it anyway. Jaren Jackson Jr. used to say the game was in his blood and
I got some beautiful hair. I am just searching for something that's real because it's really not what they say.
I got a smile, but honestly, I put my boy. Sometimes I see him in the cloud. I've been away for a while. I'm in the bed in town. Debating about who's the greatest, what you debate about. Yeah. I swear that it's always something. Get to it, I always want something. I swear that it's all assumption. Head out there, I always want something.
I got a beautiful condo, stacking my breath for the house next. They will keep trying to sign me. They do not have the amount yet. See, I come from a place where I don't usually amount. Ordered up houses across from the suburbs. That's causing the food like the northern and southern. I fight for the because society got them running in your mother's house. Cause they under your covers, there's no one to covers. That's pointing at you, they running for cover. The news ain't gonna cover, there's nothing to cover when
and the Jazz with some changes. George Niang, he's checked in for Joe Ingles. Clarkson comes in for Donovan Mitchell. And Emmanuel Mudiay subbed in for Mike Conley. Mudiay with the basket. Chris and Jaren Sr., a three-point marksman, made sure his son worked on his perimeter shooting from a young age.
Oh yeah, shout out to Jaren Sr. Even as some of Junior's coaches wanted him to focus on his inside game, Dad knew better. He said, sooner or later, son, you're going to need that outside shot. Boy, is he right.
O'Neal passes to Clarkson. No good, shot missing. Excellent D there from Allen. Kicks to Clark. Goes back up. And Jackson finishes inside. Jackson's got four this quarter.
There he is, beasting on the glass, converting the opportunity, trying to put this game away.
So active, so energetic, hoping to lead the charge for this team.
And there's the whistle on the shot. Took the foul, shot misses. He'll be shooting two.
And still trying to find his footing in the league. Mudiay must show improvement in his shooting moving forward.
Free throw missing. He's off on the second. Memphis leading by 12. Over in the corner, Allen. Off target from three-point range. Jazz have gone 8 of 14 on their shot attempts here in the third. Some pretty nice work. Shots good by Clarkson.
The thing about Clarkson, he really plays with an edge, especially once he gets it up inside.
Now here's Morant, defended by Mudiay. Kept alive. Tries again, and that one's good. Morant. Morant's got 16.
And giving up some inches inside, but makes up for it with an aggressive style.
Yeah, it's the attack mindset. I mean, that helped him prevail right there. Sometimes you just got to go with your gut.
Now, here's Moutier. Looking at his numbers, he averages a bit over 9 points a game. Puts it up from 15. That one's good, and the Grizzly lead is cut down now to just 10 on the basket from Clarkson.
And this is where Clarkson can do a lot of damage. I mean, that in-between area.
Here's Morant. And the call on the shot sends him to the line. Emmanuel Moutier picks one up.
At the line.
Really, from a physical standpoint, Ja Morant has it all. The height, the long arms, the frame to put on more weight. And few players are more explosive athletically.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
The first free throw is good. And with Morant, you not only get the physical attributes, Greg, you get the mental toughness and awareness.
Yeah, this kid loves to compete. The bigger the game, the bigger he plays. I think we're looking at a potential all-NBA performer when it's all said and done.
The Grizzlies making a switch here. Melton's checked in. No good on the second, so he hits one of two.
And what really separates Morant? The intangibles. He has a great camaraderie with his teammates already.
Here's Gobert. He gets it to fall. That makes it just a single-digit lead. Gobert's got 4 points this quarter. And here's Melton. He'll bring it up for the Grizzlies. Earlier, they held a 23-point lead.
2 minutes. Two.
The Grizzlies with another miss. Jazz trail by nine. Here's O'Neal. And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line.
Yeah, easy call.
That's his second personal foul.
He'll take his third and fourth free throw shots of the game right here.
An 80% shooter. The work he's done at the line this season. One word, solid.
That's good from O'Neal. And Memphis making a change here. Brooks checked in. O'Neal hits them both. Memphis leading by seven. Morant with it. He's got 17. Brooks outside. No good with the triple. They've shared the load offensively.
And guys, they put the defense on their heels. You can see right now they're trying to react. And that's what you want when you're in a rhythm offensively.
But three. Trains it from beyond the arc. And the Grizzlies lead by 10.
And guys, we talk all the time about making the extra pass. Clark there proving how important that concept is.
Now, here's Moutier. It's Clark with the rebound. Clark's got six rebounds in the game. And it's going to be out of bounds. The Jazz will take it.
Utah ball.
While we have a break in the action, now let's check out the league's best shooting team. Second, the Grizzlies.
So patient on the offensive end. I mean, they're not going to force shots, and it's that selectiveness that's yielded such an impressive field goal percentage.
Clarkson on the wing. He has six, and they pick up two.
Jordan.
Clarkson's got 8 points.
He's been a different guy here in the second half. His shooting percentage far better than it was before the break.
Now here's Morant. He's tightly guarded, and the Grizzlies tack on two more.
Morant! He's putting the hammer down. Dominant quarter for him, trying to push out that lead.
Jazz trail by 10. Shot clock and game clock separated by less than 6 seconds. And here's Gobert. 10 points for him. The shot by Clarkson, no good.
Well, they've been better than good on the glass today, and there is a glaring discrepancy between these two teams in that area.
1 second left. And he was able to put it up in time, but doesn't fall. And so it's the Memphis Grizzlies with a 10-point lead. Some breathing room heading into the break. A terrific tempo and a great pace. The fast break has been a central part of their offense. We've got more NBA basketball coming your way in just a minute. Here now a chance to show you our assist of the game, and it's presented as always by State Farm.
Just true artistry right there. I mean, great decision on where to go with the ball, and how about the perfect delivery?
How about the unselfishness? Night in and night out, we see guys trying to force their own agenda. Not that time.
Fourth quarter of action is upon us. Thanks as always for joining us. And the Grizzlies leading by 10. And Utah looking who they've got to start the fourth quarter. Inside, we have Ingles and Gobert. Jordan Clarkson is out there with Emmanuel Mudiay. And it's O'Neal in at the small forward. Here's Clark. Shot clock at 5. And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here. And a quick look now at how the Memphis Grizzlies schedule is shaping up. On Sunday, they'll be matching up with Nikola Jokic and the Denver Nuggets. Then on Tuesday, they'll take on Steph Curry and the Golden State Warriors.
Take a break. Take a break.
For the matchup with the Pacers, this is one where it would take a complete meltdown for them not to come away with the win. Anything can happen, but I'd be shocked if they don't come out on top.
That free throw, no good.
And missing opportunities here to extend that lead at the free throw line this half.
And he misses the second one as well, so he is 0 for 2 that time. Mudiay looking around. Clarkson finds Gobert. Pass to Mudiay. Grizzlies with the rebound. Jackson's got his fifth rebound right now in the game. It's stolen by Mudiay. To the inside. Gobert. And slam dunk by Gobert.
Well, if you don't take care of the ball, fellas, that's what can happen.
Absolutely, Greg. That makes the turnover even more painful.
Yeah, going defense to offense in an instant. Every team now calibrated to do that. Oh, even from that range, the floater is one of the toughest shots in the game.
Clarkson against Brooks. Gobert double-teamed. Stolen by Jackson. Clark, the pass to Morant. And he drops in the layup off the glass.
Morant!
And now a 12-point Grizzly lead.
This is so good at making plays in the open floor, whether Morant's running the break or finishing.
Gobert dishes to O'Neal. The pass to Ingles. Shot clock at 6. Grizzlies with the rebound. Clark's got rebound number 7 for him tonight.
And physically, there's no doubt they've been the stronger team. A plus 10 rebound advantage tells you all you need to know. Coming off a big game, his confidence couldn't be higher, and coach knows it.
And that's why they're running plays for him. They're getting him the ball and letting him go to work.
Now, here's Clarkson. Gobert, double team. Lucky 7 drops in. He's perfect from the floor. 7 for 7.
He has still not missed a shot. Where could they be today without him?
It's stolen by Moutier. Lays it in off the breakaway. Just over 2.5 minutes played now here in the final quarter of regulation. Here's Morant. Lays it up and banks it in. 6 points for Jaren Jackson.
And that's almost automatic anytime he can get the ball in that position.
Jazz trail by 12. And the Jazz call time here.
You know what? I talked to Jaren Jackson this summer, and he told me he grew another 2 inches. So let's just call him around 7 foot right now with a 7'5 wingspan. Jaren Jackson, the perfect physique for today's defensive big. He can protect the paint and maneuver outside.
Checked in for Memphis, then for the Jazz. Mitchell comes in for Clarkson, and it's Conley in for Emmanuel Moutier. And we've got an update here, so let's catch up with David Aldridge.
Hey, Kevin. Well, during the last break, I heard Quinn Snyder talking with his team. He is not happy with the turnovers. He said, we have got to get some shots. It's as simple as that, guys. Play smart and value the basketball. We'll see if the message sunk in, Kevin.
He did play power forward at Michigan State and the NBA.
Shooting.
But what's Jaren Jackson's long-term position, you think, in this league, Chris?
Well, you know what? I think he can play the 3, the 4, and the 5 with his shooting. Now, he's still experiencing guarding shorter players, and he's getting used to it. But moving his feet serves him well.
That's good from O'Neal. Second free throw, no good. Memphis leading by 11. A bit under 3.5 minutes have passed here in the fourth.
Morant.
And Morant gets it to go on the assist by Brooks.
The defense not putting up any fight on the inside. They've allowed 10 straight points in the paint.
Conley with the 3. And the rebound goes to the Grizzlies. Earlier, they held a 23-point lead. They'll host the Denver Nuggets after this one. That'll be the second of 4 games at home for them. Now, here's Morant. Brooks outside. No good from outside.
He hasn't chipped in with many points tonight. The good thing he has the guys around him to carry the weight.
Mitchell outside. It's blocked. Here's Clark. He dishes it to Morant. Pass to Valanciunas. Just 5 to shoot. It's stolen by Gobert. Now Conley. Feeds it to Gobert. Green slam dunk by Gobert.
I'll tell you what. What a good thing that he showed up today, because without him, this thing would already be over.
Now here's Morant. Floats one. Gobert with the block. But they get it back. Five to shoot. Fires from deep. And that one's good. Morant. Morant's got 9 points now in the quarter.
He showed some signs of this his last year of college. I mean, Morant cannot be left alone from distance.
Valanciunas against Gobert. Here's Conley. And he drops it in from the low post.
Assisted by Rudy Gobert.
Memphis leading by 12. Timeout called, the Grizzlies.
Every timeout, a chance to review the lineups, matchups, or call a play.
Now, that's what coaches are paid to do, right? I mean, curious to see what they go with here.
Of our Jordan player of the game, Ja Morant.
And it's been a ridiculous performance in the best sense possible. I mean, everything about his game has been working. And no matter what they've thrown at him, he's had the answer.
He doesn't take over games like this very much, but it's always possible. And when he does, here at home, these fans love it. Here's Valanciunas. Dishes it to Anderson. Morant with it. Passes it to Valanciunas. That one doesn't drop. Gobert with the defensive effort. Mitchell with it. He's picked up by Morant. Mitchell's shot is good.
They found the touch from the field here in the second half. It was a struggle in that first.
Morant kicks to Brooks. To Valanciunas. Over Gobert. No good from Valanciunas.
I like what he was trying to do. Shaking the D with the fadeaway. Tough look.
Now the pass to Conley. Gobert finds Ingles. Here's Conley. And the shot is long. And the Grizzlies leading by 10. Pass to Morant. Stolen by Mitchell. Oh, and the dunk by Mitchell.
Oh, forget about going for the long-range bomb to cut into that lead. Just take it to the hoop, my friend.
And how? Brilliant throwdown. Now here's Morant. Count it good. Morant's got 11 here in this quarter alone.
And when they've gone to him, he has come through big time. You got to keep getting him touches.
Mitchell against Brooks. And the rejection by Valanciunas. Inside, Clark. And that one is good. And it's a 12-point Grizzly lead.
Well, this is why Morant's teammates love to play alongside him. I mean, exceptional vision, and he's incredibly unselfish.
Mitchell gets to Conley. Ingles in the corner. Three-pointer. It's Clark with the rebound. Clark's got rebound number 11 for him here tonight. And Clark slams it in.
And when Clark is on fire, he stays aggressive. You gotta love how this young fella is willing to dominate games.
Now, here's Mitchell. The rebound by Anderson.
You can't look at the result of that shot. They'll take that whenever they get it.
You're exactly right. That's the kind of shot you're trying to work for at the offensive end.
Snatched away. 1:29 left in the fourth quarter.
And tonight's battle is going to end with a very clear winner, leaving nothing to chance. Impressive win for the Grizzlies.
This has got to feel good. I mean, they never counted themselves out when they were down earlier. And they not only muscled their way back into the game, but wow, they're in a position, shockingly, to win this one easily.
It's all about the will to win. You have to admire the perseverance, never doubting one another, having that trust in your coaches. And I really like what we've seen here tonight. Boy, did they earn it.
And so with this win, they'll move to 6 victories on the season.
They can chalk this one up, but these two teams will see plenty more of one another before the season's over.
Now here's Morant. And Bellinger kicks to Anderson. Now here's Morant, covered by Conley. 4 on the clock. A 3 from Anderson. A rebound by the Jazz.
And that was a little bit of a range check for him.
Oh, trying to take advantage of that extra space on the perimeter. We see a lot of this now.
That's his second personal foul. At the line for the Jazz, Joe Ingles. Taking two shots.
Two shots.
And the first one at the line is good. So he makes 1 of 2 as the second one misses. And here's Jackson. So no problem for Memphis as they get the win. Some good moments throughout this one, but they have the clear advantage down the stretch.
Yeah, I mean, I love the way they executed on both ends of the floor. Completely under control for the vast majority of the game, and whenever there was a misstep, they just didn't allow it to fester, and that's why they're going to walk away with the win.
And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Thanks, Kevin. Jonas, you have a lot on you in terms of patrolling the paint. How do you think you're doing?
I feel good. You know, there is a better game, there is a worse game, but, you know, I'm bringing energy every game, I'm fighting, and my job is take rebounds, set of screens, I'm doing a good job. You know,
it's grunt work, but you're good at it. Thanks. Back to you, Kevin.
David, thank you as always. And that'll do it, folks. For Chris Weber, Craig Anthony, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan. Thank you for being with us. So long, everyone.